हेलो, सो दिस इज़ द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ द कीज़ लाइक फॉर द असाइनमेंट इन द क्विज़. सो दिस इज़ फॉर द असाइनमेंट्स. सो लेट्स लुक एट ऑल द क्वेश्चंस एंड सी व्हाट्स द आंसर फॉर ईच ऑफ देम. सो द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज़ अबाउट टू इवेंट्स. वन इज़ अ सबसेट ऑफ द अदर. सो वी नीड टू प्रूव दैट द प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ द स्मॉलर इवेंट इज़ लेस देन दिस प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ द बिगर इवेंट. एंड लेट्स बिगिन बाई ड्रॉइंग वेन डायग्राम. सो स्ट्रिक्टली दिस इज नॉट पार्ट ऑफ द प्रूफ, बट टू गेट अ अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ हाउ दिस थिंग्स शुड बी विजुअलाइज्ड. सो यू हैव ए एंड वी नो दैट बी इज अ सबसेट ऑफ ए. सो लेट्स ड्रॉ बी विच इज बिगर देन ए. ओके, सो दिस इज बी एंड देन योर दिस इज योर ओमेगा. नाउ इफ यू सी बी, बी कंसिस्ट ऑफ टू पीसेस. ओके, सो बी हैज़ पोर्शंस ऑफ ए, राइट? सो ए बी हैज़ ए इट सेल्फ एंड देन बी ऑल्सो हैज़ पोर्शंस विच इज़ आउटसाइड ऑफ ए, राइट? सो वी विल मेक दैट ऑब्जर्वेशन फर्स्ट. सो व्हाट वी नोट इज बी इज इक्वल टू ए यूनियन बी माइनस ए. सो बी माइनस ए इज दोज एलिमेंट्स ऑफ बी विच आर नॉट देयर इन ए. ओके, सो दैट इज बी माइनस ए. नाउ मोर ओवर वी ऑल्सो ऑब्जर्व दैट बिकॉज ऑफ द वे वी हैव डिफाइंड दिस, इट्स अ डिसजॉइंट यूनियन. सो वेन एवर यू हैव डिसजॉइंट यूनियन, सो वॉट दैट मीन्स इज एनी टू सेट्स पी एंड क्यू, इफ दे आर म्यूचुअली डिसजॉइंट, वी नो दैट पी इंटरसेक्शन क्यू इज एम्प्टी. एंड इफ यू वॉन्ट टू इंडिकेट दैट इफ यू आर टेकिंग यूनियन ऑफ डिसजॉइंट इवेंट्स, यू यूज दिस नोटेशन विद अ स्मॉल प्लस इन द मिडल. ओके, सो नाउ बी इज़ अ डिसजॉइंट यूनियन ऑफ ए एंड दिस. सो नाउ वी अप्लाई एक्जियम्स ऑफ प्रोबेबिलिटी कंसर्निंग म्यूचुअल इवेंट्स, म्यूचुअली डिसजॉइंट इवेंट्स. सो दिस इज पी ऑफ ए प्लस पी ऑफ बी माइनस ए. नाउ द सेकेंड ऑब्जर्वेशन वॉट वी विल डू इज वी नो दैट ऑल प्रोबेबिलिटीज आर नॉन नेगेटिव, सो दिस इज ग्रेटर देन और इक्वल टू वन. सो दैट लीड्स अस टू द डिजायर्ड रिजल्ट. ओके, सो दैट इज क्वेश्चन नंबर वन. गिवन एन इवेंट ए एंड इट्स कॉम्प्लीमेंट, प्रूव दैट ए इज इक्वल टू वन माइनस पी ऑफ ए कॉम्प्लीमेंट. दैट इज द सेकेंड क्वेश्चन. अगेन दिस फॉर दिस ऑल्सो वी विल ड्रॉ द वेन डायग्राम, दो स्ट्रिक्टली इट इज नॉट नेसेसरी. सो दिस इज, लेट्स से दिस इज ओमेगा. ओके, एंड लेट्स कलर दिस. सो दिस इज ए, राइट? सो लेट्स, सो दिस इज सम इवेंट ए एंड द आउटसाइड थिंग इज ए कॉम्प्लीमेंट. ओके, वॉट एवर इज अनशेडेड इज ए कॉम्प्लीमेंट. नाउ इट्स ईजी टू सी इज ओमेगा इज डिसजॉइंट यूनियन ऑफ ए एंड ए कॉम्प्लीमेंट. सो नाउ अप्लाई, नाउ सिंस इट्स डिसजॉइंट यूनियन वी कैन से दैट पी ऑफ ओमेगा इज पी ऑफ ए प्लस पी ऑफ ए कॉम्प्लीमेंट. ओके, सो पी ऑफ ओमेगा इज वन. सो वन इज इक्वल टू पी ऑफ ए प्लस पी ऑफ ए कॉम्प्लीमेंट. एंड इफ यू रीअरेंज द टर्म्स यू विल गेट पी ऑफ ए इज इक्वल टू वन माइनस पी ए कॉम्प्लीमेंट. सो दिस इज क्वेश्चन नंबर टू. सो या नाउ द लेट्स लुक एट द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. सो दिस क्वेश्चन इज काइंड ऑफ कन्फ्यूजिंग. सो हियर देर आर फाइनाइट सेट ऑफ इवेंट्स, बट द इवेंट्स आर नॉट नेसेसरली म्यूचुअली डिसजॉइंट. ओके, सो what we need to do is we have to show that there is this inequality that comes in. Okay, so that is the part two. So let's see how we can solve this. So what we will do is we'll use induction. Okay, so we will start with the base case. Base case is here n equal to 2. So what we are saying is probability of a1 union a2. Okay, the question is this is this less than or equal to summation p a1 ai I equal to 1 to 2. So okay, so this is the question. Now again just for clarity, let's draw the Venn diagram. So you have omega, then you have a1 and a2, a1 and a2. Okay, so now one thing that you can observe is that you can A1 union A2, okay, is consisting of several pieces. Okay, so there are so as I was saying, there are several pieces for A1 union A2. So we can understand that A1 union A2 is actually A1 disjoint union A2 minus A1. Okay, so that is the first observation. So now we can write, since they are mutually disjoint events, so we can write this as P of A1 plus P of A2. Okay, this is what we can write. I have to be clear. This is A2 minus A1. Okay, so this is a set operation, so it's not a given. So sometimes in the past, in this question, I wrote it B minus A, but typically in the set notation, you write it in an oblique angle. So this is also equal to A2 minus A1 if you want to write it that way. Okay, so now that is the step one, but you can observe that A2 minus A1 is a subset of A2. So from previous question, we know that this is less than or equal to P of A1 plus P of A2. So this is prove the base case for n equal to 2. Okay, so now to extend this for any general n, what you do is you just say, let us assume that this proposition is true for n equal to k. Okay, and then we show that it is true for n equal to k plus 1. So how do we do this? So P of union I equal to 1 to k plus 1 ai. Okay, so this what we write is as we write it as P of union I equal to 1 to k ai, that is the first set, union ai plus 1. Now since there are, you treat this as one set, treat this as another set, we can write this as less than or equal to P of union I equal to 1 to k ai plus P of ai plus 1. Now since the proposition is assumed to be true for n equal to k, we can further break this down into summation I equal to 1 to k P of ai plus P of ai plus 1. So that proves that this is true for any n. Okay, so this is question number 3. Okay, so now moving on to the next question. So there is a partition of a set. So what does that mean? So you have omega and then you have divided into like pieces, something like this. Okay, S1, S2, S3, S4, S5, all the way till Sn. Okay, now the partition is such that any two of them are mutually disjoint. So what that means is omega is disjoint union of I equal to 1 to n si. Okay, now if when this is true, we can actually take any set. So let me just take a different color. So if you take any set, since the way you have divided, so let me just shade this so that we get the picture. So if you see, any set can be divided into all these partitions. So let me use a different set of colors. Okay, all these pieces like this. So you can divide any set into all the partition pieces. So what does that mean? You can say A is equal to disjoint union of A intersection SI. So that is something that you can infer from the Venn diagram. If you want to be more formal, I mean, if you want to prove it mathematically in a more rigorous manner, what we will do is we will do something else. We don't assume that it's disjoint union right away. So what you assume is, suppose you want to do this. So A intersection SI. So what does that give? That's the question. So if you see, this is actually equal to A union A intersection S1, A intersection S1 union A intersection S2, and so on. Okay, so now there is a distributive law in set theory. So when you have intersection of unions, you can take A out from every member. So that becomes A union, all right, A union. So all the A I am taking common, taking out, and the operation that is connected in between is not, is, yeah, so it's intersection. So this will be A intersection, sorry, because these two together, every one of them I am taking out, and individual member of the sets will be unioned, S1 union S2 all the way till Sn. Now union of all this is equal to omega, that is what is given, since it's a partition. So this is equal to A. So what you can infer from Venn diagram, you can also prove with the properties of sets. So there are two ways, and now the next step is to show that A intersection S1 and A intersection S2, they are mutually disjoint. So let us try to understand that. Next step is A intersection SI intersection A intersection SJ is empty. So this is to, you know, prove this, that they are actually disjoint union. Okay, so this for, okay, of this, of course, for I not equal to J. All right, so again we pull out A intersection common, like a distributive law of sets. So this becomes SI intersection SJ. So now A intersection SI and SJ are mutually disjoint, right? So you can see they are disjoint events. So this is going to be empty set. So A intersection empty set is also empty set. So this proves that they are actually disjoint union. So now once you arrive at this conclusion, this box over here, the next step to get this, okay, the whatever we desire is easy. You just appeal to countable additivity, that axiom. All right. So this proves next problem. Okay, so coming to the fifth question. So this question is basically, let's draw the figure for this. So what you have is, you have some A1, then you have another, A1, then you have A2, you know, something that is slowly, it is growing, A3, okay, and A4, and it on this manner, and it grows to a set, the final biggest set, it is A. Okay, so this is like you're trying to approximate the bigger set in terms of smaller and smaller approximations. So this is the first level approximation, second level, third level. Finally, in the limit, when you have taken enough accuracy, when you have taken enough care, you actually arrive at A. Okay, so that is what is the understanding. Okay, so now we have to prove this statement. Okay, so that is the question at hand. So this is a little bit tricky question. I think most people get this wrong. So let's try to understand this a little better. Okay, so we will do this following steps, and then I will explain why was it important. So let's create a set B1 which is equal to A1. Now B2 will be A1. Sorry, B2 will be B1 minus A2. This is also equal to A1 minus A2. Okay, so now B1 and B2 are mutually disjoint. Okay, similarly, B3 is A3 minus A2. So again, you notice that I am writing the difference, set difference operation in this manner. Sometimes I also write it as a1 minus a2. Either of them is fine. If you draw this way, you understand that this is a set. Okay, this is not to be confused with the conditional probability P of A1 given A2. That's not what it is. It's slightly more bent. Okay, so now B1, B2, B3 are actually these pieces. So let me just try to color this. So they are different shells. Okay, so this is B1. Then the next one is B2, then the next one, the next bigger one is B3, and so on. So basically they are all mutually disjoint. Okay, so what we can understand is that so if A is equal to union, right, I greater than 1 AI, okay, and AI in turn, this union is also equal to union BI, but this BI are mutually disjoint. So now what we can do is we can write this as summation I equal to 1 to infinity P of BI. Okay, so now here we have to understand what it means when you take a summation like this. Okay, this is a thing that you would have studied in your class 12, but yeah, so this is a idea of limit. Okay, so there is no such thing that you can sit and do the summation till infinity. That has no meaning. It's an infinite operation. It will never terminate. So the way we formally define this in math is say that this term is actually equal to limit I tending some n, so partial sums, right? So these are infinite sums, but suppose if you take the sum to a partial number, maybe 100, maybe then 300, then 500, so those numbers itself are becoming bigger and bigger. And where do these partial sums converge to? So that is what is the meaning of sum to infinity. Okay, this is a concept that you should know. Let me know if you have any questions. You can ask me over email and then I will clarify this if you have any questions. But the idea is there is no such thing as summation I to infinity in the usual conventional addition. You have to invoke the apparatus of limit. Okay, so that is where this question is a little tricky. Now at this point we again appeal to the second axiom. So we write this as limit n tend to infinity P of union BI. In fact, it is all disjoint union I equal to disjoint union I equal to 1 to n. Okay, now that is nothing but equal to, if I take union, say for example B1 union B2, what do I get? I will get so A2. So there is a mistake here. I should not be writing this in this way. This is equal to A2 minus B1 or A2 minus A1. So that is the correct expression. So when I take any, let's say if I take union of two of this, I will get A2. If I take union of three of this, so B1 union B2, I will get A2. And that union B3, I will get A3. So this is equal to An for general n. So this is limit n tending to infinity P of An. Okay, so this is what it is. So here what we did was we wrote P of A is equal to P of this, which is equal to P of this. And then that's how it proceeded. Okay, so small correction, but I guess the idea is clear. Okay. So now let's move on to the next question. So now this is a different picture. You have over approximation. So there is some set A, okay, and then you are approximating it from above. So A1 is a very coarse approximation. This is A1. A2 you are getting slightly better at it, okay, and so on till you reach the set A. You are taking approximation from above. Okay, so A is equal to intersection I greater than 1 AI. Okay, so now if you observe, right, so when AIs are decreasing, their complements are actually increasing, and that is a thing that is there in question number 5. So we can use the result from previous question to answer this if only instead of AI we had its complements. So that is easily arranged. We take complement on both sides. A complement is union I greater than 1 AI complement. So this is De Morgan's law. Okay, so now AI complements are increasing, and now we can use the previous result. So what is the previous result saying? P of A complement, okay, is limit n tends to infinity P of AN complement. So basically what is the idea of this? So what you are saying is A complement can be approximated by AN complement better and better. You get better and better. Okay, so there is, that is the idea of this. Now we write this as 1 minus P of A, and this is equal to limit n tends to infinity 1 minus P of AN complement. Okay, so we are almost done. We just cancel, we take 1 out of the limit, and then we multiply by minus 1, and that implies P of A is limit n tends to infinity P of AN complement. So that finishes all the keys for the assignment. Okay, thank you very much. If you have any questions, do let me know.